What glorifies Yahushua, HaMashiach, our Adon? Forced praise from people in their sins and despair? Or true spiritual praise in holy awe within the heart? Despite the obvious answer that holy, spiritual, awe-inspired praise is what glorifies Yahushua, many seem to think that Elohim will force people to worship him before he casts them into the lake of fire forever. That, of course, is an unbiblical interpretation many sadly believe in today. So let us see what the good scriptures, the good book, says about worship and praise, and how to worship Elohim and Yahushua HaMashiach. In John 4:24, in the Institute of Scripture Research version, we hear that Elohim is spirit, and those who worship him need to worship in spirit and truth. So worship and praise needs to be in the spirit, the Ruach of Elohim. What more does the Bible say about worship and praise? Let us hear from a fine example, Elohim's servant, King David. Tehillim, Psalm 145, ISR. I exalt you, my Elohim, O Sovereign, and bless your name forever and ever. All day long I bless you and praise your name forever and ever. Great is Yahuwah, and greatly to be praised, and his greatness is unsearchable. This psalm, like any in the Good Book, is sung with belief, holiness through Yahushua, HaMashiach, and awe before Elohim, El Shaddai. Furthermore, in the very same psalm, we read in verse 8, 9, and 10, Yahuwah shows favor and is compassionate, patient, and great in loving commitment. Yahuwah is good to all, and he has compassion on all his works. All your works give thanks to you, O Yahuwah, and your lovingly committed ones bless you. For Yahuwah does not delight in praises from unrighteous ones, those with hardened hearts. In Amos 5, verse 21 to 24, ISR, and it is Elohim who says, I have hated, I have despised your festivals, and I am not pleased with your assemblies, though you offer me ascending offerings and your grain offerings. I do not accept them, nor do I look on your fatted peace offerings. Take away from me the noise of your songs, for I do not hear the sound of your stringed instruments. And let right rulings roll on like water, and righteousness like a mighty stream. In Matthew, or Matifyahu, as the ISR render it, 15 verse 7 to 9, and it is Yahushua who says to the Pharisees, hypocrites, Yeshayahu rightly prophesied about you, saying, these people draw near to me with their mouth, and respect me with their lips, but their heart is far from me. But in vain do they worship me, teaching as teachings the commands of men. So worship and praise is to be in the Ruach, the spirit of Elohim, and in truth, which is the message of the Bible. Inspired in awe before Elohim, HaMashiach, and Ruach Ha Kodesh, and coexist with a repentant, good and righteous heart and mind through Yahushua HaMashiach, our Adon. What does the good book, the Holy Scriptures, testify about when all will praise Elohim? Isaiah 45, verse 22 to 24 in the ISR version. And it is Yahuwah who says, "Turn to me and be saved, all you ends of the earth, for I am El, and there is none else. I have sworn by myself, a word has gone out from my mouth in righteousness, and shall not return, so that to me every knee shall bow, every tongue swear. One shall say, only in Yahuwah do I have righteousness and strength. He comes to him, and all those displeased with him shall be put to shame." In Philippians 2, verse 9 to 11, "Elohim, therefore, has highly exalted him, and given him the name which is above every name, that at the name of Yahushua every knee should bow, of those in heaven, and of those on earth, and those under the earth, and every tongue should confess that Yahushua Messiah is Master, to the esteem of Elohim the Father." Romans 14, verse 11, "For it has been written, as I live, says Yahuwah, every knee shall bow to me, and every tongue shall confess to Elohim." Psalm 145 in the ISR version reads in verse 10, "All your works give thanks to you, O Yahuwah, and your lovingly committed ones bless you." All this which the good book, the Holy Scriptures, reveals, which is worship and praise in spirit and truth, begins and comes when you are given and form a personal relationship with Elohim the Father, HaMashiach the Son, and Ruach HaKodesh, the Holy Spirit. Therefore believe, confess, and turn to Yahushua HaMashiach for the forgiveness of sins and eternal life in Him.